हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर नम्रिता खिलोचिया, राफेल बीबी कॉलेज, वापी। टिल टुडे वी हैड डिस्कस डिफरेंट कंसेप्ट एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ एचआरएम। नाउ इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द एचआरएम फील्ड, दैट इज एचआरडी। नाउ एचआरडी कंसेप्ट वॉज first introduced by Leonard Nadler in 1969. According to him, HRD is a series of organized activities conducted within a specialized time and designed to produce behavioral changes. In short, HRD is working with the different improvement in knowledge, skills, aptitude, attitude and behavior of human resources in the organization. HRD in organizational context has been rightly defined by Professor T.V. Rao, and his definition, which has also been termed as the national definition of HRD in India. According to Professor T.V. Rao, HRD is a continuous process to, first one, acquire or sharpen capabilities required to perform various functions associated with the present and future needs of the job. So, first characteristics of the HRD deals with the job related capability improvement. According to T.V. Rao, second one characteristic of the HRD, that is, develop their general capabilities as an individual and enable them to exploit their inner potential. So now here, inner potential means hidden skills which needs to be improved for the future development. The third one, develop a congenial means cooperative, united organizational climate in which dyadic relationship and team collaboration among the subunits are strong and contribute to the professional well-being of employees. So third one characteristics deals with the relationship with the other department and subunits. So now we are clear with the HRD, that HRD, it is a part of HRM and deals with only development of the employees in the organization. So now we are going to understand the basic difference between HRM and HRD. Now both the terms are very important to understand, and the difference is divided into five major criteria. Let us discuss it one by one. The first one, difference criteria, that is oriented towards. The HRM is mainly maintenance oriented, whereas human resource development is development oriented. So HRM deals with maintaining the human resources and the capabilities of employees in present only, while HRD deals with the future development of the human resources, so the organization can easily deals with the future challenges by utilizing HR capabilities. Second one difference, that is organizational structure. Organizational structure in case of HRM is independent, whereas HRD creates a structure which is interdependent and interrelated. So we have also seen in the characteristics given by the T.V. Rao, HRD mainly deals with the developing better culture and climate by developing interrelated relationship with the other department. Third one difference, that is aim. HRM mainly aims to improve the efficiency of the employees, whereas HRD aims at the improving and development of employees as well as of the organization as a whole. The fourth one difference, that is responsibilities. Responsibility of the HRM is given to the personnel or HR manager. While in the HRD field, the responsibilities is given to the all manager at all the levels of the organization. The fifth one, that is motivational tools. HRM motivates the employees by giving them different monetary incentives and non-monetary incentives. While HRD stresses on motivating people by satisfying their higher order needs like promotion, career planning and development, etc. So, at the conclusion, I like to say that HRM performs many functions. So, it is a huge tree and HRD is a micro, which is only one branch of this tree, which perform the work of development of the people in the organization. So, here we are clear with the concept of HRD. Thank you, students, for listening.